Hello everyone, this is part two of the video where I create this Bella Hadid look for Swarovski holiday commercial. In the first video, we created all the outfit. In this video, I'll show you how to do all of the rhinestone necklaces and belts. Part one is linked in the description below. In this video, we start with a bare outfit and we're ready to bring all of the diamonds for the necklaces and belts. So I'm going to go to File, Import, Add, OBJ, and I will select the OBJ that is the rhinestones. I have this one and this one, so I will bring this one. Make sure that you're adding it, and I'm going to bring it as a trim, not as an avatar, and I'm going to place it right in the middle. I brought it a little higher, so I'm just going to bring it and place it right here. I can see that they're all around and they're pretty tiny compared to what I have, so I'm going to change the scale. I'm going to use the same method. I'm going to grab the pulleys here and just shrink it in height and width until I'm happy with the overall size. And then when you're happy, just click here. So I'm going to bring it here directly on the fabric. I'm happy with that placement, and I'm going to put it all around directly on her garment. Before I copy and paste all of these, I want to make sure that I have the right material. That would make it easier for me when I have to create multiples of these. So I'm going to select the rhinestones and then take a look at the properties. Gonna make it glass, and I'm gonna give it no color. Now, if you're not sure what this looks like, we can also take a look in the render window to make sure you like it. Now you can see this fully reflecting whatever fabric is underneath. This looks a little more white than crystally, so I may give the bottom of it lighter yellow, maybe a little bit more white. I'm happy with my color, so now I can create multiples of these and just place it around the body. And you can just copy paste the same one, place it exactly next to the other one, and create the shape that you like. So here's my waistband. Let's take a look and see what it looks like in the render window. Excellent. That's the first of my belts. I'll add a couple of more and a couple of necklaces and we're done. You can tell that they're pretty much the same, just smaller scale. So I'm going to go through the same process, add my OBJ files, change the scale, and then arrange them where I need them. Make sure you add them as a trim. I'm going to left click once here inside of this little gizmo, and I'm going to make this a bit more squarish and definitely smaller. I'm happy with the shape. Click back here to get the regular gizmo and then start arranging them. But before I do that, I'm also going to change all of the materials of what this is made like, and I'll make sure that it's actually on the garment. You know you're arranging it when you left click once on the bottle and you have this gray shaded outline, and now you can place it on the garment where you like. I'm going to select this and then come to the property editor. Make sure that you selected the rhinestone. Come here and then take a look at my material. Instead of fabric matte, let's make this one actually gem. And the color I can also change. And I'll take a look and see what that looks like in render, and then I'll multiply it. So I added a bit more bluish here, so I have that showing through in the render window. I'm happy with that. Now I can copy and paste this rhinestone and then arrange it here. So here's my second belt. Let's see what it looks like in the render window. Excellent. I have a slightly more bluish color here, and I have a smaller scale. I'll do one more row of smaller scale above the large one, and we'll go through the same exact process as before by bringing the OBJ file and arranging them. So here's my third belt. Let's see what that looks like in the render window. It looks like I might have messed up one of the materials here. So the base of my rhinestone is actually fur instead of gem. So we're going to change that to gem, or it could be glass. And then let's render it again. That looks better. For the necklaces, I will go through the same exact process, except this time I will create separate fabric pieces, a long piece of fabric, a short piece of fabric going around her neck, and then adding the rhinestones. Thank you. This rhinestone was imported as multiple parts. Here you can see that some are clear, some are still in the original material. So I would have to select each one of these white parts and make sure that they are actually gem or glass or whatever you like it to be, and then change the color to, again, whatever you like it to be. This will make it look more multifaceted, and it will make the light reflect slightly different depending on the colors that you use here. A quick render will show you if there's anything else left and which areas exactly also need to be fixed. This now is starting to look good, so now I can copy and paste the same rhinestone all around the choker. I'm also gonna make this choker skinnier so I don't see as much as the fabric. I wanna see mostly rhinestone. You may also want to add a stronger fabric here to hold all of these rhinestones, as they're pretty heavy and they may weigh down the fabric significantly. So I'm going to find something that's really heavy. I'm going to go with this trim full grain leather. That's still stretched out quite a bit, so I'll have to adjust the settings. I'm going to shrink this a little bit. This is holding pretty good, so I'm gonna leave it at that. And let's check out the render, and we can build the next necklaces. One more material here. I'm gonna try trim hardware and replace this fabric with trim hardware. Let's simulate and see if that holds better. This holds much closer to the neck. And one more thing I wanna do here is select this material and then bring the opacity down to zero or almost zero to have this transparent. So this way we don't see the material at all in the simulation or the render. Now the rhinestones look like there's nothing supporting them. They're just in a necklace. You can copy and paste the same exact necklace with the rhinestones and everything and duplicate it. Just keep in mind it will be really difficult and heavy to move, and it would take a lot of power from the computer. I will elongate this a little bit and just add more rhinestones as needed. You can space out the rhinestones and just keep adding more in between. If you need to see it better, you can change the color or the opacity while you're working on it and then bring it back. Select the fabric in the object browser and then work on the opacity at a higher number. Now I can see my base a lot better and I can adjust my rhinestones accordingly. If something falls off, you can just grab it and add it back on the fabric. And when you're done with that, you can change the opacity back to zero. Let's see what it looks like in the render window. And this is starting to form and shape really well. She has two short and a couple of extra long ones, so I will add a couple of more of the long ones. For this last one, I'm designated for this fabric to be glass in the render, so let's see what that looks like. You can play around with different materials here for this fabric piece and see if you change for a gem, see if that would look better, and have maybe a couple of super shiny strips here. We can also try light and see what that looks like. So I would say either the gem or the glass might work out really well. I'm gonna keep this one as a gem, and I'll leave that as one separate necklace and then add on one more long one with actual rhinestones on it. To make it easier on me, I'm gonna work on this flap. So I'm gonna reset the 2D arrangement, right click on the pattern piece in the 3D window and select reset 2D arrangement, and then maybe bring that to the side, and that should make it easier for me to arrange all the rhinestones on it. So this one I made multicolor and multi-surfaces, some of it glass, some of it gem. Let's see what that looks like when it's rendered. I'm very happy with that look, so I'll proceed with adding all of these on the long necklace. That feels like a lot of rhinestone, so I'm gonna make the base fabric a little bit wider to support all of those rhinestones better. I'm gonna change the opacity to near zero, and now I'm gonna add it to her neck and hope for the best. I wanna make sure that this lies properly, so I'm gonna utilize some pins. So I'm gonna hold the W key and add a pin on one end and then the other, and then bring those back and around. So now that I have a pin here and a pin here, when I am in simulation mode, I can just bring the pins carefully around her neck. This is definitely not a pretty process, but it should help me. Gotta give yourself really good angles, make sure that you're going around. bring them as close as possible, and then you can remove the pins. In the meantime, this stretched tremendously, so I will also have to change the material of this necklace. For this last necklace that is stretching out a lot because it has so many rhinestones, I added a trim fusible rigid material, and I'm gonna designate that to this particular pattern piece. So let's make sure that I have this one selected, assign the trim fusible rigid here, and let's watch the 3D window. This definitely lifted up the whole necklace up. So this material is helping bring this to its normal length. And now for this one also, I'm gonna bring the opacity down to zero so we don't see it here. And let's take a look at one more time in the render window, make sure that this looks really good. The only thing I wanna change is the opacity of this particular necklace here. It just looks like a blue string. And I wanna change that to look like a translucent, maybe even metallic look. And I will also change the opacity down to at least 50%. So iridescence actually looks really good. I'm gonna leave it with iridescence. You can follow the same process to add more necklaces, belts, even bracelets, rings, until you're happy with your own styling. In part three of this series, I'll show you how to create a sparkly environment and hopefully not crush your computer. If you learned something new in this video, give it a like, subscribe to Bob and Talk, and I'll see you next time.